How's it going, everyone? You got your boy Corey here, aka Crasher, bringing you guys a new exciting video. And ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to our newest episode of our Pokemon Sword and Shield competitive guides. And in this episode, ladies and gentlemen, we are going to be talking about Scentiscorch and how you can use it in competitive battles. So with that being said, guys, I am super juiced for this Pokemon in particular. I'm so juiced to talk about it because this Pokemon, in my opinion, is highly underrated when it comes to the competitive scene. And I will break down every single reason why that is here in this video. So all I ask is that you hold tight and you hear me out, because I think you guys are going to love Scentiscorch by the time this video ends. So with that being said, ladies and gentlemen, hit the like button, hit the sub button for more guides like these, and smash up in the comments down below as well, because I would love to hear from you guys as well regarding Scentiscorch. Without further ado, let us begin. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, so let's go over the basic information of Scentiscorch. So as we can see right here, it is that of a fire and bug typing. Very, very unique and interesting typing, to say the least. Kind of reminds me of a Gen 8 Volcarona in a way. But anyways, ladies and gentlemen, we have ourselves a 4 times resistant to the likes of grass, 2 times resistance to the likes of Bug, Fairy, Fighting, Ice, and Steel. Now, I want to make a real quick note on this right here. Although Bug and Steel may not be very common offensively, Fairy, Fighting, and Ice are very common offensively, so this Pokemon does boast some very unique and useful resistances. However, on the other side of the spectrum, you are very weak to the likes of flying and water. You have a 4 times weakness to the likes of rock. So flying, water, and especially rock are very common. So do keep that in mind as well for Scentiscorch. However, ladies and gentlemen, we have ourselves nothing but good things going forward, because we take a look at its 3 awesome abilities. The first of which is known as Flame Body. And what this does is that if you were to have an opponent make contact with you, there's a 30% chance that they will be afflicted with the burn condition, which is just overall really annoying, especially for physical attackers. Next up, we have ourselves the ability Flash Fire, which gives you an immunity to fire-type attacks and also boosts the power of your fire-type moves by 1 stage, which is absolutely awesome. And then last but not least, guys, we have ourselves the ability known as White Smoke, and White Smoke essentially nullifies any stat reductions from the opponent. So that means Intimidate's not gonna work, Icy Wind's not gonna work, and you know what? It's just absolutely amazing, because stat reductions from the opponent can be a little bit annoying at times. Now, moving forward, ladies and gentlemen, going on to the stats. Oh man, I absolutely love these stats, alright? So we have ourselves 100 on the HP, 115 on the attack, 65 in the defense and in the speed, and 90 in both the special attack and special defense. So as we see, when it comes to its stat distribution, its attack is the most prominent at base 115, which is very respectable in OU standards, okay? And it's also backed up with a very, very nice and clean base 100 HP, which means that it's gonna give good overall bulk. And its base 65 defense and 90 special defense is actually something to not be slept on either, okay? Because in my opinion, this Pokemon right here is what I like to call a sleeper pick, okay? I feel like that because we don't exactly see a lot of action from Scentiscorch in OU, that people sleep on it. But then here's the thing, right? Is that once the shit pops up on the field, it's like, well, shit, I ain't prepared for that, man. I don't know what to do. But with that being said, ladies and gentlemen, this Pokemon overall is just really, really nifty. It's got good stats, a little bit slow for my taste, but see, here's the thing, is that it does have some really nice form of setup, as well as just a bunch of other good moves to make use of. So without further ado, let's get on to some move sets here for Scentiscorch. All right, ladies and gentlemen, so the first set that I have for you in this how to use guide is known as the Rest Sleep Talk plus Utility Special Defensive Set. Whatever you want to call it, there's just so much awesomeness about this set right here, and we're gonna go over this shit right now. So the item of choice, I just gotta say, this item right here is a godsend, okay? It's known as Heavy Duty Boots, and what this item does is it prevents the effects of traps set on the battlefield. So that means any forms of entry hazard, spikes, forget about it. toxic spikes, forget about it. Sticky webs, forget about it. And most of all, the coup de grace, the creme de la creme, stealth rocks, forget about it. Yeah, you want to say that Scentiscorch is 4 times weak to that shit and it would have half of its health stripped away upon switching into stealth rocks? Not with heavy duty boots, baby, because that shit right there just nullifies all them entry hazards as if they didn't even exist. You know what I'm saying? So this right here is what's going to make this Pokemon great, in my opinion, in battle. So, we move on to the abilities. We are going to go with Flash Fire here because this right here not only grants us a free immunity to fire-type attacks, but also this allows for us to get a nice, nice boost to our fire-type attacks when you are hit with a fire-type move. Now, you could go for something like White Smoke if you wanted to, so that way it prevents you from having your statuses lowered by your opponents, or you could go for Flame Body if you want to have that extra little bit of mind game shenanigans and all that stuff, but in my opinion, the best bet would be to go with Flash Fire, you know what I'm saying? So, as for the moveset here, we have ourselves Rest, okay? Rest right here is going to be one of the best moves to utilize, because this right here is what's going to keep you alive and well for as long as you possibly can throughout the battle, because what this does is it puts you to sleep for 2 turns. However, it restores your HP and your statuses to maximum. And here's the thing, all right, is that rest would normally render you helpless, right? Yeah, not with Sleep Talk, friends, because what Sleep Talk does is that this allows for you to actually be able to choose a move at random while you're asleep. So this means, ladies and gentlemen, that you are not going to be total setup bait and totally helpless if you are fast asleep. You know what I'm saying? So this right here, the rest and Sleep Talk combination is just absolutely amazing. It is milk, okay? So the next move that we got going on here is known as Fire Lash. This move right here is just so bloody awesome. It is a very respectable base 80 power physical fire type move with a 100% chance to lower the target's defense by 1 stage. So you can essentially just keep racking up those defense drops and causing more and more damage. And this right here will actually put more pressure on your opponents if whether or not they want to switch out and lose momentum or risk actually being taken out of the competition when it comes to being matched up with Scentiscorch. And last but not least, guys, damn, we've got Knock Off, baby. Knock Off is a very valuable move to have on the likes of Scentiscorch, especially given the fact that so many Pokemon in Generation 8 actually lose access to Knock Off, but Scentiscorch is actually one of the fortunate souls when it comes to gaining access to it. It is a base 65 power dark type move that will deal 50% more damage if it knocks off the opponent's held item. And this right here is especially useful for Pokemon that are very dependent on their held item. You knock that shit off, well, shit, what are they gonna do now? You know what I'm saying? And last but not least, guys, let's go on to the Eevee spread right here. So we have ourselves a very specific Eevee spread right here. You want to max out the HP, so that way, ladies and gentlemen, you can have good maximum bulk overall. Like, not just for the special defense, but also physically as well, even though we're not investing in physical defense. But with that being said, having max HP is going to give you good overall bulk. And we have ourselves 236 Eevees in the special defense and 20 on the speed. Now, 20 speed EVs allows for you to outpace uninvested Corviknight. Now, Corviknight is a very, very prominent Pokemon in the OU tier. It is known as, like, I guess, the better version of Skarmory here. So, if you're faced off against the likes of Corviknight, or if you're very, very concerned about Corviknight, then you want to invest 20 speed EVs minimum, so that way you'll be able to go one-on-one with uninvested speed Corviknight. And we're going to go with a careful nature here, so that way we can have as much special defensive bulk as possible, so that way we can be really good switch-ins and answers to the likes of Dragapult, to the likes of Clefable, to the likes of Volcremie, just to name a few. There's a lot of good special attackers out there, but with a set like this, you are definitely going to give them a lot of problems in battle. Okay, so up next, ladies and gentlemen, we have ourselves kind of like a similar sort of set. You know, we are aiming to be specially defensive, but we have ourselves some differences about it, okay? First off, we are going to be G-Max Centiscorch, okay? And here is why. I'll actually go over that in just a moment, but as for the item of choice, you're pretty much always going to want to go for heavy duty boots here in this situation if you are looking to be sort of like a tanky sort of Pokemon that is meant to last in battle, but don't want to get worn down by consistently switching into entry hazards here. So, in my opinion, heavy duty boots is just the way to be, baby. You know what I'm saying? You don't have to worry about entry hazards on the field. And next up for the ability of choice, you're going to want to go with Flash Fire once again because it is a really solid immunity to fire type moves, and not to mention also a free boost to your fire type attacks. I mean, you really, really can't go wrong with that, you know what I'm saying? So the first move that we got going on is known as Fire Lash here, and this right here is going to be the same as last time. This right here is going to be utilized to lower the defenses of your opponents by one stage 100% of the time. Not to mention, it's a respectable base 80 power, and this will actually put a lot of pressure on your opponent if whether or not they want to switch out. So next up, ladies and gentlemen, we actually have ourselves Leech Life here, which is a very, very nice move for Centiscorch to have. It is a respectable base 80 power bug type attack, and what this does is it allows for you to go for the attack, and half the damage you inflict against your opponent gets converted into health restoration. So this right here gives you some form of sustain. Next up, ladies and gentlemen, we have ourselves Will-O-Wisp, because why the hell not? You know, this Pokemon gets access to it. You're meaning to be a defensive wall, so just go for Will-O-Wisp. So that way, ladies and gentlemen, you will be able to cripple your opponents even further. And even with, I just want to point this out here real quick, even with no investment in your base 65 defense, when you end up cutting the target's attack stat in half with a Will-O-Wisp burn, that base 65 defense may not look like it's so weak after all, you know what I'm saying? So anyways, lastly, we have ourselves Knock Off here, and Knock Off is just an amazing move to make use of. So that way, ladies and gentlemen, you can take care of those Pokemon that are very dependent on their held items. Now, ladies and gentlemen, let's move on here to the EV spread right here. So, we have ourselves a bit of a different EV spread right here. Kind of similar, though, at the same time. We are running a careful nature, and we are running max investment in the HP. However, we are running 72 EVs into the speed. That is so that you can outpace Corviknight that has some speed investment. I think you are able to outpace Corviknight if it has up to, I think, 52 speed EVs. So that right there is something to keep in mind as well. And the rest is just going to be dumped into special defense. So that way you have a good specially defensive bulk. Now, the reason why we are going for Gigantamax Centiscorch here is so that way it will get its special G-Max move known as Centiferno, which is going to be a buffed up fire type attack that actually traps your opponents for 4 to 5 turns and whittles them down a little bit of HP at the time. So this right here is like a built-in fire spin, and you are just going to be trapping your opponent. You're going to be overwhelming them. You're going to be just whittling them down and burning them and all that stuff. It's just going to be absolutely crazy. So that right there is just something that I kind of want to point out there as well. And not to mention also, when it comes to Gigantamaxing, like, you're just going to be twice as bulky as before. So that right there is also some pretty fun stuff. Alright, so next up, ladies and gentlemen, we have ourselves a really unique setup set going on here, and I call this the G-Max Coil set. So yes, once again, ladies and gentlemen, we are going to be going with Gigantamax Centiscorch here, and the item and the abilities are going to be the same thing. You want to, once again, go for heavy-duty boots because this right here is just too good of an item to pass up, okay? And especially when you factor in the fact that you're going to be meaning to be bulky and you are going to want to have as much staying power as possible. So switching in to a field full of entry hazards will whittle you down. But the thing is, with heavy duty boots, y'all ain't got to worry about that shit, right? And once again, we're going to go with Flash Fire so we can get that sweet, sweet fire immunity and the boost to our fire type attacks. Once again, should kind of go without saying, we are almost always going to want to run Fire Lash here because of that sweet, sweet 100% chance to drop the target's defense stat by one stage and stack up and stack up and stack up and stack up even more. Next up, ladies and gentlemen, we have ourselves Leech Life for that good bug-type stab and sustain as well. Next up, ladies and gentlemen, we have ourselves Power Whip here. So, yeah, about it being weak to water-type and rock-type moves, yeah, here's the thing is that you can go ahead and switch in your water-type and your rock-types all you want, but keep in mind, that shit is weak against grass-type moves, which is something that Scentiscorch has a banger of a move of, being Power Whip. Now, it's base 120 power with 85% accuracy, so yes, it does have some potential to miss. However, ladies and gentlemen, ring-a-ding-ding, we have ourselves Coil Up in this, man. And this is one of the best moves for Scentiscorch to have. And this right here is what is going to truly make it shine in battle when used correctly. Because what this does is it raises the user's attack, defense, and accuracy by one stage. So, yeah, about that Power Whip's accuracy there, that's going to be patched up real nice after one or two coil boosts, and you are just going to be ready to go. You know what I'm saying? So, next up, ladies and gentlemen, we have ourselves the Eevee spread right here. Now, this Eevee spread is very specific and tailor-made, so check me out on this. Okay, so we have ourselves, once again, max investment in the HP with 252 EVs. Now, we have 136 EVs into its defense, and the reason for that, ladies and gentlemen, is so that way you will never be too KO'd by Grimmsnarl's Darkest Lariat, which will hit through Coil's defense boost. But the thing is that this right here is a very important investment, so that way you can go toe-to-toe with Grimmsnarl. And also, ladies and gentlemen, a very solid note as well. After one Coil boost, Excadrill only has a 12.5% chance to OKO you with Rock Slide, and that's, I think, with Life Orb as well, you know? And also, Aegislash is going to have a lot of trouble with the set as well, and it's just going to be absolutely lovely. So, we have ourselves 100 EVs into the Special Defense, and once again, 20 into the Speed, so that way you can outspeed no speed invested Corviknight, and we are once again going to go with a Careful Nature here. So, yes, this right here is a very specific set, but this right here is something that I believe can work big time, especially when you factor in the fact that, you know, hey, you're Gigantamax, baby! So that means that you can set up and then Gigantamax and then just raise hell and be a force to be reckoned with on the field. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, so next up here, we have ourselves some other set ideas. This right here is going to be an all-out choice band set. Now, what this does is it locks you into the first move that you select, but it does boost your attack stat by one stage. And once again, we're going to go with Flash Fire because, again, you want to be able to have that sweet immunity to fire-type attacks and have a potential to boost your fire-type power as well. And once again, ladies and gentlemen, you're just going to want to go with Fire Lash. You're almost always going to want to go with Fire Lash when it comes to physical sets like this. I mean, yes, it does get access to the likes of Flare Blitz and all that stuff, which, if we can go ahead and find it, yes, right here, okay? It is base 120 power, but has a 33% recoil and a 10% chance to burn, and yes, it does thaw you out. But here's the thing, is that if we do mathematics here, after one Fire Lash, the opponent is going to be minus one in the defense, so you're essentially going to be racking up to the point where you are going to have Flare Blitz-like power, and then just it's going to snowball into more damage the more times you lower your opponent's defense stat, you know what I'm saying? So you're almost always going to want to go for Fire Lash anyways, in my honest opinion. So next up, ladies and gentlemen, we have ourselves Knock Off here because, again, Knock Off is just a really solid asset for Scentiscorch to have access to, and it does provide a pretty decent answer to the likes of Dragapult, as well as other Ghost and Psychic-type Pokemon that are weak to Dark-type attacks, and just overall Pokemon that are very dependent on their held items. Next up, ladies and gentlemen, we have ourselves Leech Life, not only for Bug-type Stab, but also for some really solid sustain, backed up by the power of Choice Band as well. And we also have ourselves Power Whip as well, so we can have ourselves a solid answer to our Rock and Water-type weaknesses. And last but not least, guys, we have ourselves the Eevee spread right here. We have ourselves 232 Eevees into its HP, 232 Eevees into the attack, 4 in Special Defense, and 20 into the Speed. Now, the reason for the Speed is, again, so you can outspeed no-speed Corviknight, and we have ourselves 232 EVs into the HP, so we can have ourselves an odd HP number, so that means you're going to have more switch-ins when it comes to switching in to entry hazards, and then I just put the 4 into special defense, because, well, why not, you know what I'm saying? And as for the nature, we're just going to go ahead and go with Adamant here, so that way you can have as much of natural attack as possible. And I just want to say as well, you can go for a Jolly Nature max speed if you want to. But in my opinion, I think it's honestly better if it's a slow attacker to begin with. Because it does have the stats to take a hit and fire back an even harder hit. Alright, so next up, ladies and gentlemen, we have ourselves a Choice Spec set. So, much like the Bandit set, we have ourselves a Spec set, which means that you are going to be locked into one attack. However, you are going to get an increase in your special attack by 50%. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, we are aiming for this Pokemon to be a special attacker here, and just hear me out on this, okay? So, next up, ladies and gentlemen, we have ourselves Flash Fire. Once again, should kind of go without saying. Anyways, ladies and gentlemen, moving on to the moveset here, we have ourselves a Bug Buzz here, which is a very respectable base 90 power special bug type move with a 10% chance to lower the special defense of the target by one stage. Next up, ladies and gentlemen, we have ourselves Fire Blast here, a very, very powerful base 110 special fire type attack with 85% accuracy, so it does have a potential to miss, and it does have a 10% chance to burn the target. Next up, ladies and gentlemen, I find it really, really funny it gets access to a move that it's actually weak to, okay? It's actually having access to Scald. That's actually really funny, okay? So, Scald is a very respectable base 80 water type attack with a 30% chance to burn. So, yeah, I mean, it is a pretty decent move overall, and the burn chance is nice, especially if you're going up against rock and ground type Pokemon that would otherwise plague you. Well, Scald is a pretty decent answer to those Pokemon. And last but not least, guys, we have ourselves Solar Beam here. Now, hear me out on this, okay? You guys are probably thinking I've lost my mind adding Solar Beam here because this leaves you open, right? You end up having to spend a whole turn charging, and then you end up unleashing the Solar Beam attack the next turn, right? Well, here's the thing, okay? Is that the reason why we have ourselves Solar Beam on here is for one simple reason. Max Flare. That's right, ladies and gentlemen. This Pokemon right here is meant to be your Dynamax Pokemon, because once it Dynamaxes, you can get off a Max Flare and set up the Sun. So that means, ladies and gentlemen, that in the duration of Sunlight being active, you don't need to charge up your Solar Beam. You can just start firing off powerful Solar Beams up in this and just be a force to be reckoned with. You know what I'm saying? So anyways, getting back on track right here, it is a special grass type move with a very, very powerful base 120 power, which is absolutely amazing. So now let's move on to the EV spread right here. We have ourselves a similar EV spread as the Bandit set right here. So we're once again going to be running 232 EVs into the HP, so that puts you at an odd HP number. 252 EVs into the special attack, 4 into special defense, and 20 into the speed. So that way you will always be able to outpace Corviknight with no speed investment. And we are going to go with a modest nature, so that way, ladies and gentlemen, you will be able to have as much special attack as possible for a choice spec set like Centiscorch. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, so now let's take a look at some notable moves in Centiscorch's move pool here, first of which is known as Flare Blitz. Now, I know I touched base on Flare Blitz earlier in the video, but I just want to point out that Flare Blitz is not a terrible move, okay? It's a very solid base 120 fire type attack, but it does have the 33% recoil, and it's just overall going to wear you down very, very quickly, and I don't think you want to have that happen. Plus, in all honesty, Fire Lash, in my opinion, is better overall when it comes to not only consistency, no recoil, but also the reliable 100% chance to lower the target's defense stat by one stage. So you're kind of getting a pseudo attack boost when it comes to the use of Fire Lash, you know what I mean? So next up, ladies and gentlemen, we have ourselves Lunge right here, which is a respectable base 80 bug-type move, and it's on the physical spectrum, and it has a 100% chance to lower the target's physical attack stat by one stage, so that right there could also face some potential as well. Next up, ladies and gentlemen, we have ourselves Mystical Fire here. which is a really nifty special fire type attack with base 75 power with a 100% chance to lower the target's special attack by one stage. So that right there could open up some pretty interesting possibilities right there. And last but not least, guys, we do have ourselves access to Thunderfang. Now, Thunderfang here is a pretty interesting move, and it's also not that terrible. It is a physical electric type move with base 65 power with a 10% chance to paralyze and a 10% chance to flinch. Now, you can use this on a Dynamax set and turn it into Max Lightning, and you could definitely cause a lot of pain to the likes of Toxapex, especially if you were to, say, combine that with the usage of Fire Lash on a Choice Bandit set, then Dynamax, and then utilize Max Lightning to cause a lot of damage, especially when Toxapex has minus one in the defense stat. Just some food for thought. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, so that right there is going to be the end here of this How to Use a Guide for Centiskorch. I really truly hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope you guys enjoyed what we talked about here. And I also hope I changed your mind as well when it comes to Centiskorch in a competitive standpoint. Because this Pokemon right here, like I said before, in my opinion, is a sleeper pick, okay? Now, with that being said, leave your thoughts down below. Tell me what you think about Centiskorch. Do you like it? Do you dislike it? Get in on the conversation, man. I want to hear from you guys. So, with that being said, thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, you know what to do. Leave a like, subscribe, and most importantly, guys, smash it up in the comments down below. Because I love, love, love hearing from you guys. Always have, always will. That ain't ever gonna change, baby. Woo! So, with that being said, thank you guys for watching. Have yourself a wonderful day or night, depending on your time zone. And I'll see you guys in the next one.